Open the book. A full page as wide as a Lincolnshire sky, with birds flying through it, flocks of words that settle in sentences and catch your eye, with images deep as a Lincolnshire sky. A story as old as a Lincolnshire track, with tales walking down it, word-built trails that carry you someplace, then bring you back, with memories long as a Lincolnshire track. Open the book now. And let's all take flight on reading strong wings to the narrative's edge. You soar with the paragraphs into the night. You don't need a torch. A book is its own light. A volume as vital as Lincolnshire air. Breathe it all in and just read. Yes, indeed, reading can transport you from here to there and flow through your life like the Lincolnshire air. Coming through on the train, through Scunthorpe, you look out at the skies. And that's the great thing about North Lincolnshire. North Lincolnshire has the most astonishing skies. Coming from South Yorkshire, where you're surrounded by a bit more hills, the skies aren't as dramatic, they aren't as wide. And so I was thinking about writing a poem that was about the North Lincolnshire skies and the way that they can be like a book, the way they can tell a story, the way that if you watch the skies for a day, they'll tell you a story of sun, they'll tell you a story of rain, they'll tell you a story of people going on their holidays, they'll tell you a story of birds flying by. So the idea was to try and make the sky, the tracks, these ancient things, feel like parts of a story.
To Christmas Island! Would you like to come with us?
North Lincolnshire Literary Trust are absolutely vital because without them you're kind of swimming in a sea of words. Sometimes you feel a bit directionless when you're learning to read. You're not quite sure who you should read and why you should read. So any kind of organisation that can help people to organise their reading can give it a kind of framework or a shape and then come up with ideas to help people to read. Because sometimes you think, what do I read next? And people who can help you and get you on the right track are definitely absolutely vital. North Lincolnshire Literary Trust can sell, this is what you do, this is how you read, this is what you write, we can organise these events, we can organise these courses, we can do this kind of thing, we can give it a framework.
Typically Tracy Beaker posed, she's going to stand with her hands on her hips like this, trying to make herself look big.
It's like when my dad went fishing, he enjoyed it that he was in the Barnsley Trout Club, because his mates would get together and talk about catching trout. And it's the same thing, it's just a group of people who are like-minded and can help you to push you on the right way. I think reading's absolutely vital because in the end, what we are people built out of language. So without language, we struggle. We can speak, of course, but written language is so important. Not only for instructions, not only for telling you how to do stuff, not only for signposts so you don't get lost and end up in Cleethorpes, not Grimsby, but things like stories, songs, novels, poems that help you to realise that actually the human being can have so much to offer, and you'll never realise that, I don't think, if you don't read. So I think reading, and then reading with its corollary on the other side, like it's a coin, so one side of the coin you got reading, on the other side of the coin you got writing. And once you read, then you want to write, and that's always a fantastic thing. I was very lucky that I went to a school in South Yorkshire that was part of the West Riding of Yorkshire, and the West Riding was a great education authority in the 60s, run by a guy called Sir Alec Clegg, who said that all children are creative. So in my school, we sang, we danced, we wrote poems, we painted, and so we just sat and wrote poems. The first poem I ever wrote, I wrote it for Mrs. Roach, and it went, "I have a little budgie in a cage of green. It is the cutest budgie that you have ever seen." And she said to me, "Ian, you haven't got a budgie." I said, "Yeah, I've got a canary, but no rhymes with canary." And I realised at that point, and Mrs. Roach actually gave me a star for that, I realised, actually, you can make it up. I think if we don't share words and ideas, then the words simply wither, they wither away. We have to share words and ideas in education. I think we have to talk to each other about what we are doing. We have to listen to what they're doing. And somewhere in the middle, education happens. You go in, you've got your idea, they've got their idea. The ideas bump against each other and a kind of friction happens and sparks fly. And you go, wait a minute, that's not a bad idea. That's a good idea. Let's try this. Let's try that. That's the great thing about education. It's not a set of rules. It's a nice dance, I think. I would say tips for young writers is always read a lot. Read a lot of poems. See how they do it. But read it as a writer. Don't just read it and think, I like that poem. Think, how have they done that? How have they done that rhyme? Why have they put that word there? What's that word doing there? Always carry a notebook around with you, because you'll have an idea and all you remember is, I had a great idea. What was the idea? You'll overhear somebody saying something strange or funny. You'll see something. You'll notice something. Write it down. Get back. Have a look at it. And maybe don't... People sometimes say, I'm going to sit and write for 3 hours tonight. Don't do that. Sit and have your writing minute. I've got my writing minute between 6 o'clock and 1 minute past six. I'm going to write something down then. So then it becomes a manageable task. That's the thing. Sometimes it becomes a huge thing, like a marathon. But it's not a marathon. It's not even a sprint. It's like just a little stroll to start with. I think reading is such a vital skill. My little granddaughter, Isla, she's 13 months old, and I found her the other day. She can't read, but she was stood looking at a book and going, ah, da, 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 da. And she understood, somehow instinctively, that when I read to her, I'm getting something from these strange shapes on the page. And to me, that is the most exciting thing, that moment that happens when you look at a book and realise that actually these odd runes on the page can make words that you can communicate with. And then that second step that goes, actually, why can't I write something? I'm a reader, but I can also be a writer. And to me, that's the exciting thing about reading, that it can read to writing, and it can read to writing poetry.